Shakespeare said it best, "That which we call a rose by any other name would smell just as sweet." Turns out, not quite. There are hundreds of rose species, thousands of cultivars. Many of them smell and others don't smell at all. But what about the rose smell we're familiar with from cosmetics, perfumes, foods, rose oil, and rose water? It's probably from a single rose species, the damask rose. And while the most famous rose smell might come from a single species, its actual scent isn't from a single source. Rose scent comes from a lot of different chemicals. One has a somewhat obvious name, rose oxide. Rose oxide produces a floral green top note, plus a sweet smell, a fruity smell, a minty smell, and a citrus scent. How does one chemical contribute all of those smells? Simple. Rose oxide isn't one chemical, it's four. All four rose oxides have 10 carbon atoms, 18 hydrogen atoms, and one oxygen atom, all connected in the same order. How do we get four chemicals from one setup? Well, it's all about chirality. Think of chirality as my left hand and my right hand. They've got the same number of fingers and one thumb. You get the idea. My hands are actually mirror images of each other. But if I try to superimpose my left hand on top of my right hand, it doesn't quite work. My fingers and thumbs don't actually line up. Left hand, 4, 3, 2, 1, thumb. Right hand, thumb, 1, 2, 3, 4. They look identical, but again, when I try to check to see if they are, I find out they're not. The same principle applies to the four rose oxides. All four have the same molecular formula, the same chemical connections between atoms, but some of the atoms are arranged differently in space. And believe it or not, that arrangement actually affects how each rose oxide smells. Scientists say rose oxide that's known as 2S4R is the stinkiest one, contributing the most to that classic rose smell. You only need about 0.5 parts per billion of 2S4R to be able to detect it with the old sniffer. Our other three rose oxides, you'll need anywhere between 50 and 160 parts per billion to pick up the scent. All four rose oxides produce different types of smells. Why the different scents and the different scent strengths? Ah, shape. Each rose oxide actually interacts differently with an olfactory receptor in our nose. Think of it as a key that fits perfectly in a lock versus one that you have to annoyingly jiggle to make work. Chemistry is full of these subtle differences. Arranging atoms even slightly differently can mean that a rose by any other configuration doesn't smell as sweet. Thanks to CAS for sponsoring this video. And hey, if you're really into molecules, check out SciFinder Future Leaders in Chemistry program. PhD students and postdocs like me from around the world are brought in to share their insights and go behind the scenes with SciFinder. It's an all-expense-paid trip where you'll get to see firsthand how CAS builds and maintains the world's most authoritative chemistry databases. You'll also get to travel to the American Chemical Society's National Meeting and Exposition. For details, visit cas.org/future leaders. Subscribe for new Get to Know a Molecule episodes every 2 weeks, along with our usual weekly videos chock full of chemistry goodness.